Hi YouTube, welcome to another video, okay? This is a video I'm gonna do for the first time of my portable electronic keyboard. It's a Casio, my second Casio that I have. I have another one, but this one is a LK30 100 Song Bank keyboard. And it has a key lighting system. It has 100 songs, 100 tones, and 100 rhythms. This is all the rhythms it's got. You can see that, Richard, or whoever. List of rhythms that it's got. That's actually the tones, excuse me, not the rhythms. This is the rhythms down there. Got a power mode switch. Has fingered chord, Casio chord, and normal. And you can change the transpose and tune of this keyboard. Also has a push button volume instead of a knob. The synchro button and a start button. Doesn't have a rewind or fast forward button like the Yamahas have. That is okay, I guess, for this era. Has a 3-step lesson computer. You can play, that's the one key, you can play it with the lesson key, and this is your part select. You select your rhythm, tones, and bank mode. This is your LCD display. Does not have an LED, it has an LED, not an LCD display. Like, similar to the DVR over there. It's red in color. It's back, you can see it at night, that's good. Multifunction display, as they say. These keys light up to indicate where what notes are playing instead of in there, which is unique. And ports, it only has an AC port, and it has a headphone output. It doesn't have anything else. It doesn't have anything else on the keyboard. Just two ports. It takes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 double A's to power it. Or an AC adapter. Got it at the Goodwill for $15. Kind of a stand. This is the original Casio keyboard adapter that fits this keyboard as well as the other model, Richard. Unplug it in. Actually had to get something out to put underneath there because the transom was big and it causes this thing to tilt. It sounds pretty good, but it sounds a lot better when I hook it up to my amplifier system, which I'm not going to do for this demonstration. I'm just going to do a brief demonstration so I don't get in trouble with the copyright police. Alright. I don't want to get in trouble with the copyright police, so I'm not going to play any particular song. I don't know if I'll get in trouble with the copyright police by playing House of the Rising Sun. I probably won't. I doubt I get in trouble with them for that, because it doesn't play the whole song anyways. I'll play it anyways. I'm going to turn it on. Turn it on to normal. The Casio chord. I'll now turn it on to normal. Put it on song. Select 14 on the LX30. You see a particular thing that it does. Actually, I'll show you. See, look. Sorry, I don't know how to play it. That's the piano. Let's demonstrate the tones. Look, let me demonstrate a rhythm that I like. If I get it out of the rhythm mode. 97 is my favorite. That is Barky. Bark you, that must be a country thing. First, let's turn on Casio chord. Invite the whole thing in. And watch what you can do. That's on synchro start. Let's go. Doesn't light up. There are sync secrets, unfortunately. Listen. Thank you. One finger. One thing that drives me nuts about this keyboard is it doesn't have an outro or intro sound to the rhythm section. That's what drives me batty about this. And it's kind of limited to what it does. See, this is limited to how much. This is the compass of the chord side, and it ends in this key, which is kind of stupid. On the Yamahas, it ends here instead of here. This one doesn't, so it throws me off when I play that. But at least that key is not active. That's cool. You can see it lights up all except this side. Okay, I'm Benjamin's ready song to a fast. Hope I don't get in trouble with the copyright police. It's called The House of the Rising Sun. It only plays parts of it. I'm going to let it play it so you can see the keys light up. Watch the both sides, and you see it light up. But I don't get me in trouble with the copyright police. I don't think it will, because it doesn't play all the song anyway. Nobody else plays it on their keyboard, so it doesn't get them in trouble, so as long as they don't play the whole song. Anyways, gonna play an unique one called Number 32, Arkansas Traveler. And I'm not gonna play it, but let the keyboard play it. And I'll end the demonstration. Retrojet might recognize this one. I don't know if Retro Chat or whoever might recognize this. It's a neat little folk song. And another one called Old Suzanne. I'm not going to play it because I really don't have time. So, that was it. That was a brief demonstration of the LK30 the Casio lighted keyboard system. It's a standard size keyboard. I believe it's 84, 83. That's a standard size usually. Most pianos of this particular time were that size. I believe this was manufactured in the mid-80s to late 90s. I'm not sure. They didn't introduce the actual or intro function into these keyboards probably until late 2000s or early late 90s or something, but this is before that. It's a good sounding keyboard. It sounds really good on the organ. It has Nearer to God to Thee, which is a song from Titanic. That plays at the end when the ship's sinking, that's why it's there. And it also has a unique little Celine Dion song called My Heart Will Go On, the Titanic theme. I don't know if this is a Celine Dion scene or not, but it's a Titanic theme. Candle in the Wind might be it. I don't know which one, but there is a Celine Dion song in here somewhere. That Killing Me Softly is not it. That's a girl in the 70s that sings that one. Well, that's it. That is basically the demonstration of the LK30 keyboard from the mid-90s to 2000s. If those of you have it, have fun and enjoy. Bye-bye.